Intel 8080. The Intel 8080 was the second 8-bit microprocessor designed and manufactured by Intel and was released in April 1974. It is an extended and enhanced variant of the earlier 8008 design, although without binary compatibility. The initial specified clock frequency limit was 2 MHz, and with common instructions using 4, 5, 7, 10, or 11 cycles, this meant that it operated at a typical speed of a few hundred thousand instructions per second. A faster variant 8080A1 became available later with clock frequency limit up to 3.125 MHz. The 8080 requires two support chips to function in most applications, the i8224 clock generator slash driver and the i8228 bus controller, and it is implemented in MOS using non-saturated enhancement mode transistors as loads, therefore demanding a plus 12V and a minus 5V voltage in addition to the main TTL compatible plus 5V. Although earlier microprocessors were used for calculators, cash registers, computer terminals, industrial robots, and other applications, the 8080 became one of the first really widespread microprocessors. Several factors contributed to its popularity. Its 40-pin package made it easier to interface Ethernet, the 18-pin 8008, and also made its data bus more efficient. Its MOS implementation gave it faster transistors than those of the PMOS 8008, while also simplifying interfacing by making it TTL compatible. A wider variety of support chips was available, its instruction set was enhanced over the 8008, and its full 16-bit address bus, versus the 14-bit one of the 8008, enabled it to access 64 kilobytes of memory, four times more than the 8008's range of 16 kilobytes. It became the engine of the Altair 8800, and subsequent S100 bus personal computers, until it was replaced by the Z80 in this role, and was the original target SPI for CP/M operating systems developed by Gary Kildall. The 8080 was successful enough that compatibility at the assembly language level became a design requirement for the 8086 when design for it was started in 1976. This also means that the 8080 directly influenced the ubiquitous 32-bit and 64-bit x86 architectures of today. The Intel 8080 is the successor to the 8008. It uses the same basic instruction set and register model as the 8008, developed by Computer Terminal Corporation, even though it is not source code compatible nor binary compatible with its predecessor. Every instruction in the 8008 has an equivalent instruction in the 8080, even though the actual opcodes differ between the two CPUs. The 8080 also adds a few 16-bit operations in its instruction set as well. Whereas the 8008 required the use of the HL register pair to indirectly access its 14-bit memory space, the 8080 added addressing modes to allow direct access to its full 16-bit memory space. In addition, the internal 7-level push-down call stack of the 8008 was replaced by a dedicated 16-bit stack pointer, SP. Register. The 8080's large 40-pin DIP packaging permits it to provide a 16-bit address bus and an 8-bit data bus, allowing easy access to 64 kilobytes of memory. The processor has 7 8-bit registers, A, B, C, D, E, H, and L, where A is the primary 8-bit accumulator, and the other 6 registers can be used as either individual 8-bit registers or as 3 16-bit register pairs, B, C, D, and H, L, referred to as B, D and H in Intel documents, depending on the particular instruction. Some instructions also enable the HL register pair to be used as a limited 16-bit accumulator, and a pseudo register M can be used almost anywhere that any other register can be used, referring to the memory address pointed to by the HL pair. It also has a 16-bit stack pointer to memory, replacing the 8008's internal stack, and a 16-bit program counter. The processor maintains internal flag bits, a status register, which indicate the results of arithmetic and logical instructions. The flags are: the carry bit can be set or complemented by specific instructions. Conditional branch instructions test the various flag status bits. The flags can be copied as a group to the accumulator. The A accumulator and the flags together are called the PSW register, or program status word. As with many other 8-bit processors, all instructions are encoded in a single byte, including register numbers, but excluding immediate data, for simplicity. Some of them are followed by one or two bytes of data, which can be an immediate operand, a memory address, or a port number. Like larger processors, it has automatic call and read instructions for multi-level procedure calls and returns, which can even be conditionally executed, like jumps, and instructions to save and restore any 16-bit register pair on the machine stack. There are also 8 1-byte call instructions for subroutines located at the fixed addresses 00H, 08H, 10 hours, 38 hours. These were intended to be supplied by external hardware in order to invoke a corresponding interrupt service routine, but were also often employed as fast system calls. The most sophisticated command is, which is used for exchanging the register pair HL with the value stored at the address indicated by the stack pointer. Most 8-bit operations can only be performed on the 8-bit accumulator, the A register. For 8-bit operations with two operands, the other operand can be either an immediate value, another 8-bit register, or a memory byte addressed by the 16-bit register pair HL. Direct copying is supported between any two 8-bit registers and between any 8-bit register and an HL-addressed memory byte. Due to the regular encoding of the instruction, using a quarter of available opcode space, there are redundant codes to copy a register into itself, for instance, which were of little use, except for delays. However, what would have been a copy from HL-addressed cell into itself, i.e., is instead used to encode the halt instruction, halting execution until an external reset or interrupt occurs. Although the 8080 is generally an 8-bit processor, it also has limited abilities to perform 16-bit operations. Any of the three 16-bit register pairs, BC, D, or HL, referred to as B, D, H in Intel documents, or SP, can be loaded with an immediate 16-bit value, using, incremented or decremented, using end, or added to HL, using. The instruction exchanges the values of the HL and A register pairs. By adding HL to itself, it is possible to achieve the same result as a 16-bit arithmetical left shift with one instruction. The only 16-bit instructions that affect any flag are, which set the PSY, carry, flag in order to allow for program 24-bit or 32-bit arithmetic, or larger, needed to implement floating-point arithmetics, for instance. The 8080 supports up to 256 input/output I/O ports, accessed via dedicated I/O instructions taking port addresses as operands. This I/O mapping scheme was regarded as an advantage, as it freed up the processor's limited address space. Many CPU architectures instead use so-called memory-mapped I/O, in which a common address space is used for both RAM and peripheral chips. This removes the need for dedicated I/O instructions, although a drawback in such designs may be that special hardware must be used to insert wait states, as peripherals are often slower than memory. However, in some simple 8080 computers, I/O was indeed addressed as if they were memory cells, memory mapped, leaving the I/O commands unused. I/O addressing could also sometimes employ the fact that the processor would output the same 8-bit port address to both the lower and the higher address byte, i.e. would put the address 0505H on the 16-bit address bus. Similar I/O port schemes were used in the backward-compatible Zilog Z80 and Intel 8085, as well as the closely related x86 families of microprocessors. One of the bits in the processor state word, see below, indicates that the processor is accessing data from the stack. Using this signal, it is possible to implement a separate stack memory space. However, this feature was seldom used. For more advanced systems, during one phase of its working loop, the processor set its internal state byte on the data bus. This byte contains flags that determine whether the memory or I/O port is accessed and whether it is necessary to handle an interrupt. The interrupt system state, enabled or disabled, is also output on a separate pin. For simple systems, where the interrupts are not used, it is possible to find cases where this pin is used as an additional single-bit output port. The popular Radio 86RK computer made in the Soviet Union, for instance. The following 8080-8085 assembler source code is for a subroutine named CODESA_1 that copies a block of data bytes of a given size from one location to another. The data block is copied one byte at a time, and the data movement and looping logic utilizes 16-bit operations. The address bus has its own 16 pins, and the data bus has 8 pins that are usable without any multiplexing. Using the two additional pins, read and write signals, it is possible to assemble simple microprocessor devices very easily. Only the separate I/O space, interrupts and DMA require additional chips to decode the processor pin signals. However, The processor load capacity is limited, and even simple computers frequently contain bus amplifiers. The processor requires three power sources, -5, +5 and +12V, and two non-overlapping high-amplitude synchronization signals. However, at least the late Soviet version 580-80 was able to work with a single +5V power source, the +12V pin being connected to +5V and the -5 pin to ground. The processor consumes about 1.3 W of power. The pinout table, from the chip's accompanying documentation, describes the pins as follows. A key factor in the success of the 8080 was the broad range of support chips available, providing serial communications, counter/timing, input/output, direct memory access, and programmable interrupt control amongst other functions. The 8080 integrated circuit uses non-saturated enhancement load and MOS gates, demanding extra voltages, for the load gate bias. It was manufactured in a silicon gate process using a minimal feature size of 6 micrometers. A single layer of metal is used to interconnect the approximately 6,000 transistors in the design, but the higher resistance polysilicon layer, which required higher voltage for some interconnects, is implemented with transistor gates. The die size was approximately 20 millimeters. The 8080 is used in many early microcomputers, such as the MIPS Altair 8800 computer, processor technology SIL20 terminal computer and IMSI 8080 microcomputer, forming the basis for machines running the CP/M operating system. The later, almost fully compatible and more capable, Zilog Z80 processor would capitalize in this, with Z80 and CP/M becoming the dominant CPU and OS combination of the period circa 1976 to 1983, much as did the x86 and MS-DOS for the PC a decade later. Even in 1979, after introduction of the Z80 and 8085 processors, five manufacturers of the 8080 were selling an estimated 500,000 units per month at a price around $3 to $4 per unit. The first single-board microcomputers, such as Micro 1 and the Dynamicro, were based on the Intel 8080. One of the early uses of the 8080 was made in the late 1970s by Cubic Western Data of San Diego, California, in its automated fare collection systems custom designed for mass transit systems around the world. An early industrial use of the 8080 is as the brain of the data graphics Autocom computer output microfiche line of products, which takes large amounts of user data from reel-to-reel tape and images it onto microfiche. The Autocom instruments also include an entire automated film cutting, processing, washing, and drying subsystem, quite a feat, both then and in the 21st century, to all be accomplished successfully with only an 8-bit microprocessor running at a clock speed of less than 1 MHz with a 64 kilobytes memory limit. In addition, several early arcade video games were built around the 8080 microprocessor, including Space Invaders, one of the most popular arcade games ever made. Shortly after the launch of the 8080, the Motorola 6800 competing design was introduced, and after that, the MOS Technology 6502 derivative of the 6800. Zilog introduced the Z80, which has a compatible machine language instruction set and initially used the same assembly language as the 8080, but for legal reasons, Zilog developed a syntactically different, but code-compatible, alternative assembly language for the Z80. At Intel, the 8080 was followed by the compatible and electrically more elegant 8085. Later, Intel issued the assembly language compatible, but not binary compatible 16-bit 8086, and then the 8/16-bit 8088, which was selected by IBM for its new PC to be launched in 1981. Later, NEC made the NEC V20, an 8088 clone with Intel 80186 instruction set compatibility, which also supports an 8080 emulation mode. This is also supported by NEC's V30, a similarly enhanced 8086 clone. Thus, the 8080, via its ESA, made a lasting impact on computer history. A number of processors compatible with the Intel 8080A were manufactured in the Eastern Bloc, the KR580VM80A, initially marked as KP580K80, in the Soviet Union, the MCY7880 made by Unitrusami in Poland, the MHB8080A made by Tesla in Czechoslovakia, the 8080A PC made by Tungsram, MEV in Hungary, and the MMN8080 made by Microelectronica Bucharest in Romania. As of 2017, the 8080 is still in production at Lansdale Semiconductors. The 8080 also changed how computers were created. When the 8080 was introduced, computer systems were usually created by computer manufacturers such as Digital Equipment Corporation, Hewlett-Packard, or IBM. A manufacturer would produce the entire computer, including processor, terminals, and system software such as compilers and operating system. The 8080 was actually designed for just about any application except a complete computer system. Hewlett-Packard developed the HP 2640 series of smart terminals around the 8080. The HP 2647 is a terminal which runs BASIC on the 8080. Microsoft would market as its founding product the first popular programming language for the 8080, and would later acquire DOS for the IBM PC. The 8080 and 8085 gave rise to the 8086, which was designed as a source-compatible, although not binary-compatible, extension of the 8085. This design, in turn, later spawned the x86 family of chips, the basis for most CPUs in use today. Many of the 8080's core machine instructions and concepts, for example, registers named A, B, C and D, as well as many of the flags used to control conditional jumps, are still in use in the widespread x86 platform. 8080 assembler code can still be directly translated into x86 instructions, all of its core elements are still present. PCs based upon the 8086 design and its successors evolved into workstations and servers of 16, 32 and 64 bits, with advanced memory protection, segmentation, and multiprocessing features, blurring the difference between small and large computers. The 80286 and 80386's protected mode were important in doing so. The size of chips has grown so that the size and power of large x86 chips is not much different from high-end architecture chips, and a common strategy to produce a very large computer is to network many x86 processors. Federico Fagan, the originator of the 8080 architecture in early 1972, proposed it to Intel's management and pushed for its implementation. He finally got the permission to develop it 6 months later. Fagan hired Masatoshi Shima from Japan, who did the detailed design under his direction, using the design methodology for random logic with silicon gate that Fagan had created for the 4000 family. Stanley Mazur contributed a couple of instructions to the instruction set. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.